There was a time when most sci-fi books or movies began with the words, in the year 2000 or it's the 21st century, expecting an amazing age of advanced science and technology. They weren't entirely wrong. We constantly witnessed the creation of things once thought impossible. In the first of our three-part series on the fourth industrial revolution, our Ijuan zooms in on soft robotics, the field drawing a growing number of young researchers with innovative ideas about how to design their world.
Robots are often depicted as big, boxy machines made of steel. But that stereotype may not hold true in the near future, because in the fourth industrial revolution, a new type of robot is starting to emerge. And Korea's student researchers are right in the thick of it all.
Universities are on vacation this time of year, but the research labs here are still working day and night. Let's go visit one of them.
This team specializes in soft robotics and develops non-rigid robots made from silicon, rubber, and other soft materials to better replicate the movements of living creatures and perform tasks that existing robots can't. Among the many projects on the team's to-do list, the exoglove pulley is one to keep an eye on. The glove is designed to help people who suffer from paralysis of the hand and fingers by enabling them to grasp and pinch objects.
It works like the human hand. When the tendons that run through the glove are pulled, the fingers close and grasp the object.
The gadget has been gaining a positive response worldwide for its portability, simple yet compact features, and user convenience, including its washable materials. It's already on its way to being mass-produced for commercial use, but people have already been asking when and where they can buy it. And on top of the new possibilities the gadget offers people with difficulties moving their hands, it's also served as an inspiration to its developers.
By participating in the research for exoglove poly, I saw how even a small robot could be a big help to people with disabilities. I felt a strong motivation to continue developing robots for rehabilitation.
Over in another corner of the lab is a small robot with transformable origami wheels that can change size and shape depending on the circumstances.
This is a search and rescue robot. Its wheels will shrink when it needs to squeeze itself into a narrow passageway, but when it needs to climb stairs and go over rocky surfaces, the wheels get bigger.
The innovative wheels are one of the features that landed the team and their robot Snowmax in first place at the first ever RoboSoft Grand Challenge last year.
The challenge was held to introduce the new paradigm of robotics and show what soft robots are capable of doing. And our Snowmax, which has various features our lab has been working on, was able to overcome the obstacles in the challenge, including moving on sand and climbing upstairs.
Having spent time developing this kind of robot, the team is familiar with the challenges and the failures that can come long before any success. But the researcher says that it's from those failures that innovative ideas arise, and that transforming his ideas into working robots is what made him excited about soft robotics.
When developing these soft robots, we have to start from scratch, because they run very differently from rigid ones. But it is for that reason that we can think outside the box and really be able to implement more of our ideas in the robots.
Their work and open approach are already attracting many young researchers.
People in wheelchairs have difficulty when they encounter obstacles in their path, so I want to develop a spider leg-like chair that can just take giant steps and walk over it.
While most robots are fast and durable, they're not very flexible, and soft robots are able to make up for these disadvantages. However, they also need to be better at delivering power and a faster reaction time, so I hope to work on these areas.
Although soft robotics is relatively new, many researchers say it'll eventually come to define the field.
Many robot engineers will agree that the perfect robot is a living organism, and I believe these soft robots will eventually open up a whole new paradigm in robotics. And our professor says in the future, soft robotics won't be the subtopic, but will define robotics itself.
이지원, 아리랑 뉴스.